Hi, this video is about programming an Intel 8080, 8085 and Zilog Z80 in assembler. So if you're not interested in 8-bit CPUs or assembler programming, this video is probably not for you and it would be better to leave now unless you want to get bored to death or maybe want to stay to fall asleep, who knows. In this part I will give a quick overview of the hardware and an introduction to binary and hexadecimal numbers. Are you still with me? Great, then let's start with the hardware. The CPU was released in 1974, and the year of this recording is 2019, that is 45 years ago. You needed three different operating voltages and two custom chips for the clock generator and system controller. The 8085 was released 2 years later. You needed only 5 volts and no clock generator and system controller. They were both integrated. The Z80 was also released in 1976. And the founder of Zilog is Federico Faggin, who left Intel after building the 4004 and 8080 CPUs. What do they have in common? The DIP case and the 8080 machine code. You can run 8080 code on an 8085 or Z80. What is different? The pinout and the hardware interrupts. Let's have a quick overview of the pinout. I will only mention the differences between the CPUs. On pin 20 is a 5-volt input, on pin 11 the -5-volt, and on pin 28 there are 12 volts. On pin 14 you will find the interrupt pin. On the 8085 you have 5 interrupts. The INTR is the same interrupt as the INT on the 8080. The TRAP is a non-maskable interrupt and the RST pins are additional maskable interrupts. The pins 80 until 87 are the lower 8 bits of the memory address. It's a multiplexed address data bus. The lower 8 bits of the memory address or I/O address appear on the bus during the first clock cycle of a machine cycle. It then becomes the data bus during the second and third clock cycles. The SOD and SID represent the serial interface. SO stands for serial out and the SID for serial in. On the Z80 are 2 interrupt pins. NMI stands for non-maskable interrupt, and the INT is in interrupt mode 0, compatible with the 8080. There's a refresh pin that can be used as a refresh address to the system's dynamic memories. Let's have a look at the CPU registers. First, the 8-bit registers. A is the accumulator, F the flag register, B, C, D, E, H, and L. And now the 16-bit registers, SP for the stack pointer, PC for the program counter, and now the Z80 only registers. I, the interrupt page address register, R, the memory refresh register, IX and IY, the two 16-bit index registers, and the alternate register set, the quote registers. In the decimal system are 10 digits from 0 to 9. 10 to the power of 1, of 0 is 1, 10 to the power of 1 is 10, then 100 and 1000 and so on. Nothing new. And for the binary system, there are only 2 digits from 0 to 1 and to the power of x. Eight bits represents 1 byte. If you add these numbers together, you will get 255. In the binary system, you have 2 states, 0 and 1. 2 to the power of 8 equals 256. That means 1 byte represents numbers from 0 to 255. If you take just 1 bit, 0 in binary equals 0 in decimal, and 1 in binary equals 1 in decimal. With 2 bits, 0, 0 equals 0, 0, 1 equals 1, because the least significant bit represents 1. 1, 0 equals 2, because the second least significant bit represents 2. 1, 1 equals 3. 2 and 1 is 3. With 3 bits, you have the following. The third least significant bit represents 4. 4 and 1 is 5, 4 and 2 is 6, 4 and 2 and 1 is 7. In the hexadecimal system, there are 16 digits from 0 to 15. The numbers from 0 to 9 are identical in both systems. The differences are between 10 and 15. Ten equals A, 11 equals B, 12 equals C, 13 equals D, 14 equals E, and 15 equals F. The letters A to F have nothing to do with the registers. They represent just numbers in the hexadecimal system. If you take the hex number 3e, that's 3 times 16. 16 because 3 is in the second position from the right. E equals 14, and 1 because the first position from the right equals 1. 3 times 16 equals 48. At 14 equals 62. How do you convert hex numbers to the binary? That's very simple. Let's have a quick look at the binary format. From the 8 bits, we only need the 4 lower bits, because that's enough to represent numbers from 0 to 15. If we take the number 3, that's in binary 0011. The quality rating is 1, 2, 4, and 8. Let's look only at the 1s and ignore the 0s. 1 and 2 equals 3. The same goes for e. E is 14. Let's look only at the 1s and ignore the 0s. 2 and 4 is 6 and 8 equals 14. So we have already covered the binary to hex conversion. Let's do one last example. Look only at the green ones from the right to left, but consider their respective positions. That's 1 and 2 and 8, which equals 11. And 11 is represented as a B in hex. Now the yellow ones from right to left, 1 and 2 and 4 equals 7. So the hex numbers are an easy way to represent binary numbers. You don't have to convert them first to decimals to get the binary representation, and vice versa. There are a lot of free simulators out there, even for smartphones, but one for the Z80 is more challenging to find. I will use the 8085 and Z80 simulators from Ocean Software. They are not free, but I think you can run them in demo mode without a valid license. Here is the overview of the 8085 simulator. You will find the accumulator and the flag register here. They are called together as program status word, PSW. The main registers are over here, B, C, D and E. The registers H and L, also referred to as the data pointer. The serial port is over here. And here we will find the program counter and also the stack pointer. The flag register is shown in binary format. These are the same. Here is a quick look over the Z80 simulator. The main registers are here. Their corresponding alternate registers. The flag register in binary format and also the alternate flag register. Here are the 16-bit index registers, IX, IY, stack pointer and program counter, the special registers called I and R, and here the interrupt control flags. Let me give you a quick demonstration before the end of this video. I'm switching back to the 8085. O-R-G is an assembler keyword, which means the start of the program, in this case at address 4x0 in hexadecimal. The mnemonic to load a value in a register is called move immediate. I don't like this expression because it is not a move, it's more load. MVI. You can write it in uppercase or lowercase. I prefer the lowercase. Accumulator with the value 10. If you don't specify anything behind the numbers, the assembler thinks it is a decimal value. So for example, let's load B with 33 in hexadecimal. And the last one, D, with the value ABH. And if it is a hex number and it starts with a letter, you have to specify 0. So 0, H, B, and H for hexadecimal. And finally, an HLT. HLT stands for halt. That means That means the CPU is waiting for an interrupt or a reset. The assembler has converted the mnemonics to machine code. That's a code that the CPU can execute. In this case, at address 0000, the byte 3E means load the next value in the accumulator. And the next value in this case is A. Let's do it here. Start. We are at program counter 00. We are here in step-by-step instructions. So with step, it takes the first command, loads A in the accumulator, and now the program counter is at memory address 2. Memory address 2 is here the next command with step. B is loaded with 33. Program counter is at memory address 4. And next command is load D. D is loaded with AB. Program counter is at memory address 6. And that's a halt command. And the program is finished. Let's do the same with the Z80 simulator. Here the syntax is different. It's actually LD for load, A comma, let's take the same example. Load B, load D, and the halt command. And the halt, you'd have to write the whole word. Not HLT, but HALT. Let's do an assemble and load. And here you can see it's exactly the same machine code as the 8085. This is the 8085 code, and this is the Z80 code. So let's do a quick check. PC counter at 0, 3E. E is loaded. Program counter increased with two steps because it's a 2-byte command. B, 33. D, AB. And the halt command. Okay. See you in part 2. Bye bye.